That is exactly what a carbonated soda should look like.
Hey guys, King Yoshi left a comment down below asking if we could make our own carbonated drinks using dry ice. And with almost 800 likes, this is by far the most popular comment, so that's what we're trying today. We're making fizzy drinks on the DIY. Now we're all familiar with that customary hiss that you hear when you open a bottle of soda. The actual noise that we hear is the pressure in the bottle rapidly escaping out the top, and the reason that most sodas begin to fizz as you do is because the carbon dioxide dissolved in the solution begins to nucleate and rapidly come back out. Now the first step in making fizzy soda or a fizzy drink is to start off by making fizzy water. Now I just went down to the grocery store and picked up a bottle of San Pellegrino sparkling natural mineral water. Very posh stuff, right? But if you open it up and pour some out, you'll find that it's basically just water with a little bit of fizz. And that fizz is really the only thing that makes it sparkle. There's really no sweet taste to it at all. It literally is just fizzy water. And that's exactly what we're gonna make next. So now that we know what high quality fizzy water tastes like, let's go ahead and take a shot at making our own. Quick update guys, here's what I just did. I took a little bit of water and poured it into a separate glass and then got a chunk of dry ice I picked up at the grocery store and used my mini master sword to smash it up into smaller chunks. Now watch very carefully to what happens if we grab some of those smaller chunks and toss them into the water. That's pretty much the typical dry ice water reaction, but something else is taking place that you may not have realized the last time you saw this done. The water around the dry ice is actually getting fizzy. Eventually, the water around the dry ice will get so cold that it'll form a layer of ice, which will act as an insulator, and it'll actually prevent the dry ice from bubbling off as quickly. But right now, you can see it's forming a vapor barrier, a gas barrier around the dry ice, which looks really, really cool. It almost makes it look lacquered. All right, guys, so it's been about 4 minutes. Our dry ice has almost completely dissolved. Now, occasionally, I'll get somebody who asks me, what would happen if you drank the water that has the dry ice in it? So I'm gonna try that for you now. It's fizzy. And you know what? It almost tastes the same as our San Pellegrino. We just made fizzy water by throwing dry ice into it. Isn't that interesting? The San Pellegrino does have more of a bite, more fizz, and I'm pretty sure that's because it's got more carbon dioxide dissolved into the water. However, if we dropped in more dry ice and let it run longer, I'm pretty sure we can achieve a very similar effect with our homebrew. So now that we know we can make our own sparkling water using just a few chunks of dry ice, let's go ahead and take it to the next level and see if we can make carbonated drinks.
Where'd all the juice go?
It like turned into a mash. Okay, so not a great way to get orange juice. So here we are guys, I just poured some drinks and cut up some fruit and now we're left with four different glasses. We've got lemonade, apple juice, orange juice, and watermelon juice. Now as is, none of these drinks are fizzy at all. I've tasted each of them and they're completely flat. So the next step is to grab a few handfuls of dry ice, fill our glasses full, and let them sit for about 20 minutes to see if our drinks carbonate themselves. Quick word of advice, if you ever try making orange juice for yourself, don't include the peels. This stuff tastes terrible. Pugh. Mmm. Oh yeah, watermelon. That's a win. Here we go. Guys, here we are. It's been about 25 minutes and each of our cups is still bubbling away. However, one thing that's very interesting is the dry ice is so cold it actually forms a layer of ice around it and acts as a little bit of an insulator, so it does slow down the bubbling process quite a bit. So this has all looked really cool and we made a huge mess, but here's the real question. After 20 minutes of experimenting, have our drinks turned into fizzy drinks? Here we go. It's very cold, and I do feel the carbon dioxide bubbles tingling on my tongue, just like you would with a soda. We've effectively just turned our apple juice into sparkling cider. That's very cool. It's just too bad half of it's frozen. You know, I just had an idea for that frozen stuff. If we scoop that out, we get ourselves a nice carbonated slushy. Cool, fizzy, and refreshing. All right, next up we got our sparkling lemonade. That's what I call a chilled beverage. Let's see how it tastes. Yeah, it's fizzy, it's carbonated. That actually has a really pleasant taste to it. That's tickling my throat. That's cool. Yeah, I quite like that. I highly recommend dry ice and lemonade. Good combination. All right, this monstrosity of orange juice that I attempted to make. It's very fizzy and it tastes terrible, but it definitely is fizzy. Very cool. This one I'm very much looking forward to. This is the watermelon, which tasted great before. Can't wait to see how it tastes fizzy. Effervescent. Yep, it's pretty much what you'd expect carbonated watermelon juice to taste like. It is nice, but honestly, I think I prefer this one flat. Big win on the lemonade though, that's good stuff. You gotta try that. Now just for fun, I went ahead and filled up a big bowl with the rest of the apple juice, threw in a few chunks of dry ice, and just let it sit for about 20 minutes. Then I took some of that juice and I transferred it using a funnel into this Coke bottle and screwed the cap on tight. And if you shake it up, you can actually feel it pressurize, and looking at it, you can see all the same soda bubbles and fizz that you would expect to see out of a carbonated drink. So I think at this point we've effectively turned regular apple juice into something very similar to that sparkling cider you get for special occasions. Homebrew non-alcoholic sparkling cider. And if I remove the cap, yep, I'd say that's fizzy. We did it, homemade fizzy drinks. Makes a mess just like the rest. Taste test. So you can see as we were pouring those out, the Martinelli's actually had a little bit more foam, froth, a little bit more of a head at the top there, and that's because it's got more carbon dioxide actually dissolved into the fluid. But now that it's sitting out at standard atmosphere, let's go ahead and give it a taste test. Oh my goodness. That is really, really good. I mean really good. That's our homemade stuff too. All right, original Martinelli's. Almost identical. They taste almost identical. That is super cool. I'd say this one tickles the tongue just a little bit more. No, I take that back. This one is just as fizzy. So at standard atmospheric pressure, these things taste almost identical. This one tickles the tongue. It's got a nice aftertaste. It's delicious. They taste identical. And I think I prefer this one because it's even a little bit colder. A natural side effect from using the dry ice. So interesting stuff, guys. The purpose of this experiment was to see if we could use dry ice to make our own improvised carbonated beverages. And apparently, the answer is yes, we can. Although it's not nearly as practical or as easy as just going down to the store and buying something, but it definitely is a lot of fun. You might be wondering if you can use this trick to rejuvenate a flat soda as well, and the answer is yes. If you take a very small chunk of dry ice, and I mean very small, like no bigger than your thumbnail, and drop that down into your container and screw the cap on tight, the bottle immediately begins pressurizing and the carbon dioxide begins to dissolve back into the liquid. And honestly, this really isn't something that you should try at home because putting dry ice in a sealed container, in a lot of cases, will make it explode. So there you have it, guys. That's how to use a little bit of dry ice, some juice, some water, or whatever else you like to make your own carbonated drinks at home. Just make sure you don't use too much dry ice and don't put it in a sealed container because it could explode. And of course, a big thanks to King Yoshi for requesting this experiment and to everyone who helped support him. Go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Mr. Yoshi. I'm sending you $25. Thanks for joining me for this experiment. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. It gives it a really cool shimmer. It's so shiny. Yeah. This one I'm very much looking forward to. This is our watermelon juice. It tasted so good before. I'm very much looking forward to how it tastes now. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.